Hi, I'm Lucy and this is Eat Britain. As promised, this week I'll be explaining the difference between all the welfare standards you can find on your pork to help you with your shopping. We'll be covering organic, free range, outdoor bred, outdoor reared, RSPCA assured and red tractor assured. We'll also at the end be covering the US standards and the EU standards and compare them to our own. So here we are on an organic or a free-range farm, which can be very similar. The animals are free to roam around indoors or outdoors as they please. They have lots of natural materials to have as bedding and to root around in. And the mother pig, the sow, has lots of materials to make a nest in to have her baby piglets in, which is a very natural and important thing for a pig. The difference here between the organic and free-range farms is the food they eat. And on an organic farm, they would have organic food, and on a free-range farm, it's quite likely they would be having GM food, as would be the case on all the other welfare standards. The second difference is that if on an organic farm, the pigs had to have antibiotics, which is very rare as it is on a free-range farm because the animals have plenty of space and are stress-free. But if they did happen to have antibiotics, there has to be a cooling off period between when the animal has antibiotics and when they are slaughtered to reduce the chances of the antibiotics remaining in the meat when you consume it. On a free-range farm, this is not required. The third difference is when the baby pigs are weaned from their mother, so that means taken from having milk from them. This on an organic farm would be 5 to 6 weeks, and on a free-range farm this would actually be 7 to 8 weeks. They stay with their mother for a bit longer on a free-range farm. If they were just in nature, they would usually wean at around 12 to 17 weeks, so that just gives you some perspective there. Here we have the welfare standards of the red tractor label, or it's also the same as UK legal minimum standards. There's not much difference there. Here you will expect the pigs, the baby pig and the mother pig, to exist on concrete slatted floors. Their slats allow the poo to fall down so that the cleaning of the pig facilities is more efficient. You will also expect here that the mother pig will give birth in a farrowing crate. This is to prevent the piglets from being crushed by her when she gives birth, and she spends the last 5 weeks of her pregnancy existing in this farrowing crate where she will not be able to move around much at all, you can see from the pictures. With this welfare standard, you'll expect that lots of antibiotics will be used. This is because the cramped conditions, illness obviously spreads quite easily. You will expect here that the piglets will be weaned from their mothers at age 3 weeks. A practice which is very common on a red tractor assured farm or a UK legal minimum is tail docking. This is cutting off the piglets' tails to prevent them from biting each other's tails as they grow up and get in each other's ways. This prevents infection from them biting each other's tails. Tail docking is not permitted on an organic or free-range farm. Here we find ourselves back outside in a very relaxed environment, similar to the free range and organic farm, for the outdoor bred and outdoor reared label. Here the piglet and the mother exist in relaxed indoor and outdoor conditions up until age 3 weeks. There are no farrowing crates. The mother builds her own nest to have the piglet in, and the piglet is weaned from the mother at age 3 weeks. And then they will usually be given antibiotics as they'll shortly be moved into an intensive farming situation. This happens at aged 4 weeks with an outdoor bred and aged 10 weeks for a outdoor reared. So at this point, the baby piglet will end up in an intensive farming environment at the standards of a red tractor or UK legal minimum standard. Just to give you some perspective, the piglet, the fattening pig, will spend, depending on various factors, between 50 and 80% of its life then in the intensive farming environment when it's outdoor bred or outdoor reared, depending on whether it's outdoor bred or outdoor reared, and depending on how long its life is. So what can you expect with the RSPCA label for a mother pig and a baby pig? Well, first of all, a lot more space. There are no slatted floors if the pigs are kept indoors, and there'll be more bedding and more nesting materials for mother pig to have her baby pigs in, and there are no farrowing crates. So that covers the welfare standards for UK pork. Just for your reference, if you decide to buy pork from the EU, the legal minimum standards there are the same as the UK standards, except there's one difference. They may be in sow stalls, the mother pigs, the sows, for 4 weeks of their pregnancy, in addition to the 5 weeks in a farrowing crate. The sow stall is very similar to a farrowing crate. If in the future you decide to buy pork from the US, what you can expect there, well, the regulations are a lot more relaxed. The mother pig, the sow, could be in a sow stall slash farrowing crate for her entire pregnancy, as there's no restrictions there. There's also no restrictions on tail docking. They will have antibiotics in their feed most of the time, so they do consume a lot of antibiotics. And there's also no requirements with regards to bedding or nesting materials. I hope you found today's episode useful. If you did, like and subscribe. If you'd like a bit more information, in the description below there's a PDF which has a chart going into more detail. Next time I'll be reviewing a Riverford organic vegetable box. Thanks for watching.